pop the champagne.
All right, Karen, you want to start the vlog out?
Yeah, you know, I could.
Okay, you go ahead.
You seen it, you know it, you love it.
We're in the woods.
We went up a hill.
Sarah Brooks is on the vlog. Welcome to the vlog.
Thanks, Elliot. Happy to be here.
What you got?
Cold brew. I'm that girl that drinks a cold brew in the winter.
Yeah, on a balmy 45 degree Minnesota heat.
Look at that view. It's actually nice up here.
Yeah.
And we have been hiking for about, what would you say?
40 seconds.
40 seconds?
Mm-hmm.
We'll see where we're gonna end up. Could be anywhere.
Yeah. Elevation gain. Gains.
Elevation gains. We took a vow in summertime, and now we find ourselves in late December. That way?
Yeah, that way.
Maybe we should do a mobile Q&A, do it on the road.
Alright.
Wanna start?
Sure.
So, oh, another choice, kind of. Wait a minute.
Oh, man.
That might be the spot.
That's the spot, never mind. See that spot? You know what that is? That's a spot. Always know what the heck? This is so cool. Wow.
The red dot is on.
Oh my gosh. It's safe. We're on a rock in the Rasmussen wilderness area.
River rock coffee.
Yes. And this is, you know, somewhat the end of an era. I'm leaving school tomorrow, so this is like 18 St. Peter vlogs of 2020.
Oh.
And so we got some celebratory beverage, booze.
Wow. And oh yeah, I'm not 21 yet.
Oh my goodness.
So this vlog is gonna be called Underage Drinking with Sarah Brooks. Oh, I didn't bubble over.
Ah, pop the champagne.
No! How you do it for episode 18. All right, a group of some great friends answered my cry, my plea for questions for both of us. Some of them were for you, some of them were for me. All right.
Wait, should we cheers to this Q&A?
Yeah, we probably should. Cheers to Q&A.
Cheers to Q&A.
All right, first one. Let's start lighthearted. Kyle Wilson asks, Sarah, what's your favorite kind of cheesecake?
Oh, no, this is hard. Probably just straight up chocolate, lots of it. The
chocolate.
Dark kind.
Yeah, I always would get the chocolate cake there.
Oh my gosh, that's like kind of rude.
Eli asked it. I like the question. What brand do you have the most loyalty to?
Target. They have all the needs and it's cute. Do you hear that too?
Yeah, it'd be fun if like a deer walked up on us. Okay, Luke Schultz. Never mind, we'll skip Luke Schultz's question for now. Lauren asks, this is such a Lauren question. If you could have a giant bowl of anything, what would you have?
Popcorn.
Really?
Yeah. I do often. I have this big bag from Woodman's. It's like this bag and you could get 2 for $9. It's light,
is it the skinny
salted.
Pop?
No.
I'd probably do Sour Patch Kids. I wish that wasn't the answer, but
that's okay.
I'm still trying to work them out of my life, but
no,
it's hard.
It's okay.
They're just so darn good.
Mm-hmm.
CJ Fury asks, how many times do you think Sarah Brooks can jump in the air as high as she can consecutively?
Oh.
I guess the way it's phrased is probably a question for me. So you decide what the actual answer is, as I'm sure you've tested
this before.
Okay, read
it again, please.
How many times do you think Sarah Brooks can jump in the air as high as she can consecutively?
I like that question.
It's such a CJ question, too.
It is such a CJ question.
Like, this would be like, great. They'll love this one. I think the answer would be, like, if you're just talking, like, almost a squat jump, just like, jump, land,
yeah.
Jump. And
to get maximum height, you have to explode.
I'd say 62, because then at that point, you're not jumping as high as you can.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to be too tired. That's just my guess, though. What's the actual answer?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. The answer is 105.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
When's exactly. The last time you did that?
Yesterday.
Mm. Cool. Emma says, I don't know what this means, but I think that means you should go into it. Do you have a good combination that other people consider whack? I guess that kind of makes sense. Like, two things that you do together or combine?
Oh.
I bet Emma has one. Emma, you should comment what you had in mind when you asked this question.
Yeah, I'm curious. I feel like that's definitely an Emma question. Well, I don't know. When I was younger, I always used to have peanut butter and banana sandwiches. And I, like, have told some people about it, and, like, no one else has done this. Or, like, they thought it was kind of weird, so kind of wacky.
That's kind of wacky. The next question was supposed to be a call-in question. According to this person, they couldn't explain it over text. They had to... Hey, Eli.
Hey, Eli.
Hey,
what's up?
We heard you had a question.
I do have a question. Okay, so here's the situation. You are standing at the bottom of a 45-degree hill, a very steep hill. Behind you is the ocean, okay?
Okay.
When you're facing this hill, in front of you, at the top of the hill, running towards you is a full-grown alpha male walrus. He is charging, and your job is to stay alive. With you, you have two things. You have a walrus tusk, and you have a Gillette three-pronged razor. You have two choices with the razor. It can either have a cord, or it can be cordless. That's your choice. The other choice that you have is, on one of your hands, you only have two fingers. Your job is to stay alive. How do you do it? So make sure that you specify two things. You need to make sure you specify what two fingers you have on which hand, and you have to make sure you specify if the razor is corded or cordless. Keep there's going. A lot of silence going on.
I think that my razor would be cordless because there's no, like, what do you, you can't plug it in, so it'd be not a choice.
Okay.
And then, wait, two fingers on one hand?
Either left or right. One of them has five fingers, the other has two.
Can I have six and one? I feel like my strongest fingers would be my thumb and my pointer finger. So I think I would maybe go with those. Or like, no, middle finger and thumb. Because I feel like then you...
Middle finger is very important.
Yeah. Because then I could like get, like hold it better. Like hold something better.
Okay.
Can I run to the left or the right?
Yeah, you can run to the left or right, but it's not going to get you very far. It's a full-grown walrus. He can intercept you.
Would it work if I let the walrus slide into the water and then I electrocute it?
Oh, I think I like the idea, but I don't think it would electrocute him because it's an ocean and that you would have a couple of batteries working in your favor. That's about it.
Hmm.
But you know, if that's what you want to try, that's an acceptable answer. What are you doing with the walrus tusk?
Oh, I forgot about that. Well, then I could, with the couple batteries, then it would help me to finish the job, to stab the walrus.
Okay. To stab the walrus?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
I think that's the best I got, Eli. Did I live?
I'll have to discuss. This is a request I have with another person. I'll have to discuss with him and get back to you. I don't think it's looking good, though.
Oh, man.
Why don't you leave a comment on this vlog after it's posted and share the results?
I definitely will. So keep your eyes out for that comment.
Deal.
Thanks, Eli. Check the comments if you want to know if Sarah survived or not. What was your first impression of Sarah Brooks? I think that's a question for you.
Okay, yeah, so I think that
I met you at a teen retreat. Mm-hmm. You remember that teen retreat? So to me, you were just like a person seeing camp for the first time, and you were like obviously more reserved and shy. But then the next memory after that I have with you is going out to Milty Wilty with you and Katie.
Yeah.
And I, like, to me that was, I thought it was really cool because I thought of you as like cool. Let's see if we have any good ones left. I love Grace's question. I'm gonna spell out exactly how she said it. She says, would you rather have toes for fingers or fingers faux toes? Here's how she spelled it. Faux toes. I think that you don't explain it. She didn't ask for explanations. Don't explain it.
I was gonna explain it.
Fingers for toes.
I have to process this in my head. Toes for fingers. Yes, toes for fingers.
Oh, okay.
I really want to explain.
Okay, explain.
So I remember learning that in like the Chinese culture that you really rely on your toes, pinky toe, I think, especially for balance. And so if all your, oh wait. Never mind, this doesn't make sense. I don't know what I was thinking. Never mind.
Emily Pyatt asked, who is your dream guest to make an appearance in one of your vlogs? It already
Stop
happened.
It.
She also asked when she's going to be in a vlog, Emily, soon. That's the Q&A.
So fun.
We didn't fall off the edge. Thank you for all your questions, everyone who asked.
Good questions.
I hope you're satisfied with the answers, and I hope that you survived the walrus attack.
And you'll comment. Yeah.
That's what we got. Oh my goodness.
It's red.
It's Sarah and I are nodding in sync right now. You should know that.
It's awesome. That's the vlog.